What's up guys, Faded here, and welcome back to my channel for another video. And today I have an overclock video for you on the 4770K, and this is getting that chip to a nice 4.5 GHz. Now one thing before we start here is that most of these settings will probably not work for you. You are going to have to tweak some of these on your own. But this video will give you a nice ballpark estimate of what you're going to need and give you a place to start. Now some cards, you know, they're just not able to overclock at all. It just happens. It's kind of the luck of the draw whenever you buy a chip. But I think most people should be able to achieve 4.5. Now another thing is cooling. Do not, I repeat, do not even try to attempt this if you have stock cooling. You need adequate cooling. You will kill your chip. So anyways guys, let's go ahead and dive right into this. Now the CPU base clock, that needs to be at 100 unless you really know what you're doing, but I would just set it to 100 and that keeps everything safe. Now a clock strap, set that to auto. I usually set my apply mode to next boot so you are not making live changes, or you know, sometimes that can cause instability, you know, because you're making changes as you go, and then that really throws off voltages and such. Now, CPU ratio is the frequency at which you want to get to. So, in this case, we want to get to 4.5 GHz, so we're going to set this to 45. Set CPU ratio mode to fix. That way all the cores are working at the same level, you know, and you're not having one core working less than the other. They'll all be working the same. Ring ratio, you want to be as close to your CPU ratio as possible, but some can go higher, some can go lower, you know, some get better results when they're higher, some get better results when they're way lower. It's just kind of, you know, you got to experiment with this one. I'm setting this one to 42, but you're going to have to experiment on that one on your own. Now if you have overclock profiles or XMP profiles for your RAM, which you probably already have set up, but do keep in mind that more voltage in your RAM will cause more instability. You could be halfway into a overclock and you can't really figure out why, and that could be your RAM causing instability. So I would suggest maybe you just lower your RAM to maybe 1333, and so that cuts out all your RAM, and then you can just go ahead and find a nice stability with your CPU and then go ahead and up your RAM later. Now VCCI in voltage, set that to auto. CPU core voltage, you know, while you're testing, you're going to want to set this to override, because you know, benching programs, stress testing programs, they will make the voltage run too high because they'll override the settings. So the best thing to do is just set this to override while you're trying to find stability, and then once you find stability you can change it back to adaptive. And then also on this, you want to set that one to 1.25. And like I said earlier, you're going to have to tweak these settings until you find something that fits you. Now voltage offset to auto. Now ring voltage mode, set that to override as well until you find stability, just like before. Set the voltage to 1.2, but I wouldn't go over 1.25, but you will have to tweak and experiment here as well. Ring voltage offset mode and offset to auto. Now SA voltage, you will want to set the offset mode to plus, and the physical offset to 0.25. IO analog, set that to plus and 0.195. Same thing here with IO digital. Now all of these values you're going to have to tweak a bit until you find something that is stable for your chip. It's just something that every overclocker has to deal with, because no chip is the same. VR protection I would disable, but only if you have adequate cooling, you know, like I said earlier, and you are absolutely sure that you want to push your chip and you want to push it way past the specifications, because this is one of the only forms of protecting you from frying your chip. You can leave the rest of this to auto and enable. Now one more thing before you save and exit, you do need to go into your CPU features. Within CPU features, you will see something like Intel C state. I've disabled this because otherwise I get instability, and there's pretty much two options when overclocking this far, and that's to either disable Intel C state or enable it and then set the package to C0. This has to do with the idle state of the CPU, so when you're not using it, it will try to conserve energy, but sometimes you'll all of a sudden, you know, need more juice, and then the clock goes up, but it doesn't have enough power, so then you crash right into the ground and you get your blue screen. And you know, C0 just doesn't quite cut it for me, so I disable it entirely. So anyways, let's go ahead and recap some of these settings here. VR disabled, IO digital to plus, you know, 0.195, analog to plus 0.195, and SA voltage to 0.25 and override till you find stability. Ring voltage to 1.2 and override till you find stability. Core voltage to 1.25, same thing there as well. Set XMP or other RAM frequency, but keep in mind stability issues with higher voltages. Ring ratio to 42 and test until you find a stable amount. Ratio mode fixed, CPU ratio to 45, and base to 100, and boom, you're done. You can save and exit. But make sure you do test for stability and monitor your temps for at least a whole day. Most people recommend 2. I would say, heck, go for 3. But 1 is usually enough to find stability. But you could be going, you know, half the day, and then like maybe a few hours later you'll get a crash. And so it's always good to extensively test your overclock. So I wish you the best luck, and you can find more information on this specific overclock at overclockersclub.com. And once again, the link will be down in the description. If you are having issues, feel free to drop them in the comments and I'll give you my best shot and I'll help you out as best as I can. But overclocking is in no way guaranteed, guys. You might not even be able to overclock it past its specifications. So good luck and thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe for more tech videos, and you guys have a good one.